Hello, and welcome to the Bible with Briscoe 2022. I am your messenger of the Word of God, Shenandoah Briscoe, and today we're going to be covering 2 Chronicles 30 through 31 and John 18, 1 through 18. Father, I just ask for clarity of voice and articulation, so that the reading of your Word will be a blessing to you, and for all of those who have tuned in from all around the world. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And they all said, amen. Hezekiah celebrates the Passover, 2 Chronicles 30. Hezekiah sent word to all Israel and Judea, and also wrote letters to Ephraim and Manasseh, inviting them to come to the temple of the Lord in Jerusalem and celebrate the Passover of the Lord, the God of Israel. The king and his officials and the whole assembly in Jerusalem decided to celebrate the Passover in the second month. They had not been able to celebrate it at the regular time because not enough priests had consecrated themselves and the people had not assembled in Jerusalem. The plan seemed right both to the king and to the whole assembly. They decided to send a proclamation throughout Israel from Beersheba to Dan, calling the people to come to Jerusalem and celebrate the Passover to the Lord, the God of Israel. It had not been celebrated in large numbers according to what was written. At the king's command, couriers went out through Israel and Judea with letters from the king and from his officials, which read, "People of Israel, return to the Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, that he may return to you who are left, who have escaped from the hands of the kings of Assyria. Do not be like your parents and your fellow Israelites who were unfaithful to the Lord, the God of their ancestors, so that he made them an object of horror, as you see. Do not be stiff-necked as your ancestors were. Submit to the Lord. Come to his sanctuary, which he has consecrated forever. Serve the Lord your God, so that his fierce anger will turn away from you. If you return to the Lord, then your fellow Israelites and your children will be shown compassion by their captors and will return to this land, for the Lord your God is gracious and compassionate. He will not turn his face from you if you return to him." The couriers went from town to town in Ephraim and Manasseh, as far as Zebulun, but people scorned and ridiculed them. Nevertheless, some from Asher, Manasseh, and Zebulun humbled themselves and went to Jerusalem. Also in Judea, the hand of God was on the people to give them unity of mind to carry out what the king and his officials had ordered, following the word of the Lord. A very large crowd of people assembled in Jerusalem to celebrate the festival of unleavened bread. In the second month, they removed the altars in Jerusalem and cleared away the incense altars and threw them into the Kidron Valley. They slaughtered the Passover lamb on the 14th day of the second month. The priests and the Levites were ashamed and consecrated themselves and brought burnt offerings to the temple of the Lord. Then they took up their regular positions as prescribed in the law of Moses, the man of God. The priests splashed against the altar the blood handed to them by the Levites, and since many in the crowd had not consecrated themselves, the Levites had to kill the Passover lambs for all those who were not ceremonially clean and could not consecrate their lambs to the Lord. Although most of the many people who came from Ephraim, Manasseh, Asherah, and Zebulun had not purified themselves, yet they ate the Passover contrary to what was written. But Hezekiah prayed for them saying, "May the Lord, who is good, pardon everyone who sets their heart on seeking God, the Lord, the God of their ancestors, even if they are not clean according to the rules of the sanctuary." And the Lord heard Hezekiah, and he healed the people. The Israelites who were present in Jerusalem celebrated the festival of unleavened bread for 7 days with great rejoicing, while the Levites and priests praised the Lord every day with resounding instruments dedicated to the Lord. Hezekiah spoke encouragingly to all the Levites, who showed good understanding of the service of the Lord. For the 7 days they ate their assigned portion and offered fellowship offerings and praised the Lord, the God of their ancestors. The whole assembly then agreed to celebrate the festival 7 more days. So for another 7 days they celebrated joyfully. Hezekiah, king of Judea, provided 1,000 bulls and 7,000 sheep and goats for the assembly, and the officials provided them with 1,000 bulls and 10,000 sheep and goats. A great number of priests consecrated themselves. The entire assembly of Judea rejoiced, along with the priests and Levites and all who had assembled from Israel, including the foreigners who had come from Israel, and also those who resided in Judea. There was great joy in Jerusalem, for since the days of Solomon, son of David, king of Israel, there had been nothing like this in Jerusalem. The priests and the Levites stood to bless the people, and God heard them, for their prayer reached heaven, his holy dwelling place. Second Chronicles 31. When all this had ended, the Israelites who were three there went out to the towns of Judea, smashed the sacred stones, and cut down the Asher poles. They destroyed the high places and the altars throughout Judea and Benjamin, and in Ephraim and Manasseh. After they had destroyed all of them, the Israelites returned to their own towns and to their own property. Contributions for war. Hezekiah assigned the priests and Levites to divisions, each of them according to their duties as priests or Levites, to offer burnt offerings and fellowship offerings to the ministers, to give thanks and to sing praises at the gates of the Lord's dwelling. The king contributed from his own possessions for the morning and evening burnt offerings and for the burnt offerings on the Sabbaths, at the new moons and at the appointed festivals, as written in the law of the Lord. He ordered the people living in Jerusalem to give the portion due the priests and Levites, so that they could devote themselves to the law of the Lord. As soon as the order went out, the Israelites generously gave the first fruits of their grain, new wine, olive oil, and honey, and all that the field produced. They brought a great amount of a tithe of everything. The people of Israel and Judea who lived in the towns of Judea also brought a tithe of their herds and flocks, and a tithe of the holy things dedicated to the Lord, their God, and they piled them in heaps. They began doing this in the third month and finished in the seventh month. When Hezekiah and his officials came and saw the heaps, they praised the Lord and blessed his people Israel. Hezekiah asked the priests and Levites about the heaps, and Azariah, the chief priest, from the family of Zadok, answered, "Since the people began to bring their contributions to the temple of the Lord, we have had enough to eat and plenty to spare, because the Lord has blessed his people, and this great amount is left over." Hezekiah gave orders to prepare storerooms in the temple of the Lord, and this was done. Then they faithfully brought in the contributions, tithes, and dedicated gifts. Kenani, a Levite, was the overseer in charge of these things, and his brother Shimei was next in rank. Jehiel, Azaziah, Nathan, Eshel, Jeremoth, Jezebad, Eliel, Ishmaka, Mahath, and Benaiah were assistants of Kenaniah and Shemaiah his brother. All these served by appointment of King Hezekiah and Azariah the official, in charge of the temple of God. Kor, son of Imnah, the Levite, keeper of the east gate, was in charge of the freewill offerings given to God, distributing the contributions made to the Lord and also the consecrated gifts. Idan, Minimah, Jeshu, Shimeah, Amari, and Shechaniah assisted him faithfully in the towns of the priests, distributing to their fellow priests according to their divisions, old and young alike. In addition, they distributed to the males 3 years old or more, whose names were in the genealogical records, all who were entered the temple of the Lord to perform the daily duties of their various tasks, according to the responsibility and their divisions. And they distributed to the priests enrolled by their families in the genealogical records, and likewise to the Levites 20 years old or more, according to their responsibilities and their divisions. They included all the little ones, the wives, and the sons and daughters of the whole community listed in these genealogical records, for they were faithful in consecrating themselves. For the priests, the descendants of Aaron who lived on the farmlands and around their towns, in any other towns, many were designated by name to distribute portions to every male among them and to all who were recorded in the genealogies of the Levites. And this is what Hezekiah did throughout Judea, doing what was good and right and faithful before the Lord his God. In everything that he undertook in the service of God's temple and in obedience to the law and the commands, he sought his God and he worked wholeheartedly, and so he prospered. That was 2 Chronicles 30 through 31, and now we will be turning to John 18. Jesus arrested. John 18. When he had finished praying, Jesus left with his disciples and crossed the Kidron Valley. On the other side there was a garden, and he and his disciples went into it. Now Judas, who betrayed him, knew the place, because Jesus had often met there with his disciples. So Judas came to the garden, guiding a detachment of soldiers and some officials from the chief priests and the Pharisees. They were carrying torches, lanterns, and weapons. Jesus, knowing all this was going to happen to him, went out and asked them, "Who is it you want?" "Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "I am he," Jesus said, and Judas the traitor was standing there with them. Then Jesus said, "I am he." They drew back, and they fell to the ground. Again he asked them, "Who is it you want?" "Jesus of Nazareth," they said. Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he. If you are looking for me, then let these men go." This happened so that the words he had spoken would be fulfilled. "I have not lost one of those you gave me." And then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, and he struck the high priest's servant, cutting off his right ear. And the servant's name was Malchus. Jesus commanded Peter, "Put your sword away. Shall I not drink this, the cup the Father has given me?" And then the detachment of soldiers, with its commander and the Jewish officials, arrested Jesus. They bound him, and they brought him first to Ananias, who was the father-in-law of Cephas, the high priest, that year. And Cephas was the one who had advised the Jewish leaders that it would be good if one man died for the people. Peter's first denial. Simon Peter, another disciple, were following Jesus. Because the disciple was known to the high priest, he went with Jesus into the high priest's courtyard, but Peter had to wait outside at the door. The other disciple, who was known to the high priest, came back, spoke to the servant girl on duty there, and brought Peter in. "You aren't one of these men's disciples too, are you?" she asked Peter. He replied, "I am not." It was cold, and the servants and officials stood around a fire that they had made to keep warm. Peter also was standing with them, warming himself. And that was John 18:1-18, which concludes the Bible with Briscoe 2022 for today. Tomorrow we will be covering 2 Chronicles 32-33 and John 18:19-40. Father, I just thank you for your word, because if it were not for your word, I would not be able to be your messenger of the word. So I give you all the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. And they all said, amen. I'd like to thank you folks for tuning in to the Bible with Briscoe 2022 for today. Please like and share so that it may be spread throughout the world. Thanks again, and as always, you know, God loves you, and so do I, so come back and see us tomorrow, because, well, God willing, we'll be here, and we hope that you are.